operation. We started on the 13th of this month, 13th of October, by withdrawing our stores and non-essentials. We shall start the second phase of withdrawing our personnel, the first units to go to back to Uganda. Then we have the last phase will be on 13th, on 30th, hopefully this month on 30th. That's when we shall be moving the last. That's when we shall move the last units out of South Sudan.
When you first deployed in South Sudan on 19th December, you had objectives as a force. Do you feel you have achieved those that you had set out to do?
Our mission here has been so far very successful. First of all, we came here when there was a lot of fighting, when there was killings of people by the rebels, and we stopped that. In other words, we stopped a would-be genocide. Two is that our coming here created a fertile ground for the negotiations, the peace negotiations that have been going on by IGAD member states and the government of South Sudan and the rebels.
When you first came into South Sudan, Parliament had not approved that deployment, and so the arguments that you were only warmongering and you were getting into a war that was not your war. What do you say to your critics?
SPLA, they are our friends for a long time. We fought Konya together, we fought the government of Khartoum when it was trying to Arabize South Sudan. We were together fighting, so it's, our bond is historical. So what affects South Sudan directly affects Uganda. If there is insecurity in South Sudan, Uganda also gets insecurity. So when there is fighting in South Sudan, we get a lot of refugees. So Uganda has to be directly involved in every conflict that takes place in South Sudan.
You're leaving South Sudan because of the agreement that says that Juba must be demilitarized and the army must leave 25 kilometers away from Juba. Do you feel that you're leaving this country in safe hands? Because the arguments that it is still a toddler in terms of, you know, its army.
Yeah, it is still a young force, but they have built capacity. I think they'll be able to defend themselves, but not fully. You know, it took us even in Uganda a long time, you know, to build capacity, to professionalize the army. It took us years. South Sudan is a young nation. They have a young army, so they still have a lot to do. I don't think they will be able to do all the work. Only if the UN could bring in its force to do what we have been doing here, to help them, you know, build capacity.
What are the chances that we could see another deployment of UPDF here in South Sudan?
If such happens, if need arises, we are always ready to come back here.
This has been a very big group that was deployed in South Sudan. What happens to them after here?
First of all, when a professional army is not fighting, it is training. We are going to continue with training.